Hello, how's it going? Today I am sharing what codependency is and what codependency is not. You know, because codependency, it can show up as a lot of different things. There's a lot of signs that could point to you being codependent. However, there are really three distinct factors that equate to being codependent. And so today I'm going to tell you what those things are. So if you're feeling a little bit confused about what codependency is, this is the right video for you. And if you're new to my channel, I want to first introduce myself. My name is Allison. I talk about mental health struggles, particularly in relation to, or as a result of, growing up in a dysfunctional family, how it negatively impacted me and maybe you as well, and how I am moving forward, living a healthier and happier life, and how possibly you can too. And so if you relate to that, go ahead and subscribe to this channel so that we can be a part of each other's lives and experience this journey of resiliency together. Welcome. That being said, the three factors that equate to being codependent are: one, denial. So particularly in one certain relationship or system of relationships, like a family, there is denial about the real nature of the relationship or of individuals within the relationship. So maybe you're in denial or minimizing, that's a form of denial, how bad things are or how you're not doing well. Maybe because of the other person, you know, you don't want to blame the other person, but like that can happen. You and another person, you don't mesh and you're not accepting that. You're in denial of that. And I also want to say that this denial can be completely subconscious. Denial is the first quality of codependency. The second is a lack of communication. There's a lack of open, honest expression of how I'm feeling, what's going on with me, thoughts, ideas that arise, probably due to concern of what reaction, what response open communication would bring. So maybe rage, maybe fear within us, or shame, guilt, obligation, bad stuff. And so there's not open communication. And this also extends beyond this relationship that may have a codependent quality, because we may not be openly communicative with our friends, with the people around us about how we're doing, about what the relationship is like, things that are happening, things that are being said, things that are being done. There's not open communication. That's the second quality of codependency. And the third is a lack of emotional expression. Similar to communication, there's not true expression of how we're feeling. Maybe we're feeling a lot of resistance within this codependent relationship, but there's also this enmeshment, which is not codependency, but it's very similar. So quickly, what enmeshment is a lack of boundaries and an unwillingness to set boundaries in a relationship. And that alone is not codependency, because perhaps there is acknowledgement of the nature of the relationship, of the fact that it's perhaps toxic or just unhealthy or perhaps just not right for you at this time. But there's an unwillingness to actually set the boundaries. That's enmeshment. And another thing that I'll say is, moving beyond the three factors of codependency, which are denial, lack of communication, lack of emotional expression, you could experience these three factors and maybe enmeshment within one relationship, possibly a relationship with a family member who struggles with substance abuse or with a personality disorder or difficulties. But that's not necessarily codependency. You're more so considered codependent if these three things extend not just in one relationship or a system of relationships, but into your entire life. So if you are bringing this denial of the nature of how you are or how your relationships are, a lack of open communication and honesty, and a lack of full emotional spectrum in your whole life, in all of the relationships in your life, in how you relate with the world, in how you relate with yourself and connect with yourself, that those three things in almost every area of your life, that is when you are truly codependent. And so, the good news is, by knowing this, you can come out of denial and realize that this is something that's affecting your life. And you can go on moving forward, learning more about codependency and how to heal from it. But for today, I am going to leave it at that for you to digest. And I also want to share that I will be creating a video on how I moved from denial to really being aware of my codependency, but not willing to really set boundaries. So like still a little bit in denial, like fighting the codependent nature of my relationships to the point where these relationships were really ruining my quality of life, my peace of mind, my sense of safety in the world. Denial to life-ruining codependency to now when I'm healthy. I'm going to share that story in a video coming very soon to screens near you. So again, I welcome you to join me on my journey by subscribing, leaving a comment, saying hello, how's it going, and or just staying around and watching me do my thing over here on this little corner of the internet. So I have to go, but thank you so much for spending this moment in time with me today. I really appreciate you, and I hope that this moment in time was valuable for you. I wish you the best rest of the day, rest of this little moment in time ever, and I will talk to you soon. Peace.